Hi, this presentation is going to go over confidence intervals for the mean when we have large samples. We begin by defining a point estimate, which is a single value used to estimate a population parameter, and the most unbiased one is the mean. Mu, the sample mean, is x bar. So here's an example. If we have a random sample of 32 textbook prices rounded off from a college bookstore, and we want to find a point estimate for the population mean, the best estimate would be the sample mean, $74.22. So whereas a point estimate is a single point, an interval estimate, as you probably imagine, is a range of values that would likely surround a point estimate. So from the previous example where we had the sample mean of 74.22, we can also look at a range of values likely to fall around that in the population. So how confident do we want to be that the interval estimate, that is this range of values, will contain the actual population mean? And that's how we define the confidence interval. The level of confidence comes from, or is denoted by the letter C here, and it refers to the probability that the interval estimate will actually contain the population parameter. So here in this graph, we have C as the area between, within the normal curve, between two critical values. So we use the standard normal table to find the corresponding z-scores, and we figure out the cumulative area in between two points. There are a few common levels of confidence that are used in such tests. At 90% in a two-tailed test, we have a cumulative area of 0.9 between the z-scores of 1.645 and negative 1.645. And so on the right and left tail, we have 0.05, because recall that the overall cumulative area is going to equal 1. And so if we divide the remainder by 2, we get 0.05. 95% confidence interval, we have slightly different z-scores, the cumulative area 0.95, the remainder is 0.05, it's a two-tailed test, so we have that divided by 2, so 0.025 in what we'll call the critical zone. The third common level of confidence is 99%, so you can see this outside area just keeps shrinking with the wider we draw our confidence interval. So next we can look at the margin of error, and the margin of error is of course a interval around the sampling error, and since we don't know whether or not our sample estimate is actually the population parameter, we need to come up with a margin to give us confidence that we're at least in the ballpark, so to speak. So the formula for getting the margin of error is shown down here, where E, which represents error, is Z times standard error, and when N is greater than 30, the sample standard deviation can be used to estimate the population standard error, and that will be the standard deviation over the square root of N times Z. So that will give us our margin of error, and then of course we go plus or minus with that margin of error. So here's an example, and going back to our textbooks, we have 32 from a local college bookstore with a mean $74.22 for the cost, and a standard deviation of the sample of $23.44. If we have a 95% confidence interval, that gives us a z-score of 1.96, plus or minus. And we know that the critical region outside of that is going to be 5% divided by 2, 2.5% or 0.025. And when we use that formula, we get $8.12. So we're plus or minus $8.12 around the point estimate of $74.22. So the confidence interval C for population mu is the probability that the confidence interval contains the actual population mean represented as x minus e is less than mu, and x bar plus e, is the upper bound. So we have the lower bound and the upper bound, with the middle containing the actual population parameter. And so with our 95% confidence interval, as we saw, we have 74.22 for x bar minus e, or x bar plus e, which is $8.12. And here is that graphed out. So we've got 74.22 there on this line, and then down here is the lower bound, which is minus 8.12, which comes out to 66.10, and plus 8.12 gives us 82.34. So those are the range of values that make up our interval. So to summarize, these are the steps involved in finding a confidence interval for a population mean where n is greater than or equal to 30, or the population standard deviation is known, and it's a normally distributed population. So the first step is to find the sample statistics n and x bar, important over here in symbols. Specify the standard deviation if known. Otherwise, if n is greater than 30, we find the sample standard deviation and use it to estimate it. And that's how we do that with this formula. The square root of the sum of square deviations over n minus 1 degrees of freedom. Next, we find the critical value, z subscript c, that corresponds to the given level of confidence. And for that, we use the standard normal table. And then we find the margin of error, e, using the formula z subscript c times standard deviation of the population divided by the square root of n. And then finally, we use that to find the left and right endpoints that form the confidence interval. And the left, of course, x bar minus e, and the right, x bar plus e, and the interval expressed with this formula, with that equation, rather. So here's another example to demonstrate these steps. If we have a random sample of 25 students, and they had a grade point average with a mean of 2.86, and past studies have shown the standard deviation is 0.15, and the population is normally distributed. If we construct a 90% confidence interval for the population mean grade point average, this is what it looks like. So N25, X bar 2.86, and in this case, we don't have to estimate the population standard deviation because we have the information. And we also would note that it's less than 30, so we wouldn't actually want to use the formula shown in the steps because it doesn't meet the criteria. So with that, we also, based on our 90% confidence interval, find the from the standard normal table the value 1.645. So in building our margin of error estimate, we use this formula, 1.645 times the standard deviation over the square root of the sample, so 0.15 over 5, and times 1.645 will give us roughly 0.05. Therefore, when we build our interval, we have 2.86 plus or minus 0.05. Here we want to estimate the mean price of all textbooks in a college bookstore. How many books must be included in your sample if you want to be 99% confident that the mean will be within $5 of the population mean? So in this example, you'll see we're really just rearranging the previous formula to solve for n rather than to solve for e. So in this case, we already give e as $5. So if we plug in the values here, z for 99% confidence interval gives us, from our standard normal table, the value 2.575. And we knew the standard deviation of the population is 2344. Multiply those and divide by the given e value, which is our error value, $5. Then we know that we need n to be 145.7. And we always round up, so 146 people is what it would take for us to achieve this 99% level of confidence that we contain the actual population mean within our interval.